What's up, spectators? Welcome back to the episode of Layton. We are still investigating the case of the White House horrors, and we're trying to find whatever cases that we haven't learned yet, so we need to eventually get inside Madame Dublay's house. But let's speak with at least one more person before we step inside. The night is ripe, right for puzzle solving, am I right? If the puzzle's interesting enough, I'd happily solve it anytime. Yes, I'm sure you would. You obviously have puzzles under your skin already. What a weird creep, man. Watch this puzzle be something like, how do I get a body from my house into my car and bury it? A group of monsters has appeared. Defeat all the monsters and level up all three of the heroes to 5. They each need a different number of experience points to level up. Blue needs 5, yellow 10, red 15. Slide the heroes on the top of the enemies to attack it. It's also possible to undo a move by touching the attacked enemy. Let the battle commence. So does that mean the number represents... Okay, How many attacks do I get? Well, I guess we'll find out in a second, won't we? Oh, this is interesting. But how do you get to the front lines? Oh, I see. Oh, no. Oh, no. I see. This is interesting. Okay, let's try this again. That was fun. Okay.
Puzzles are made for solving.
A puzzle I enjoyed. A unique puzzle. I've never seen one like that in any of the Layton games so far. Well, was it as satisfying as it promised to be? Get out of here, you creep. I always enjoy a good puzzle. Yes, you do. And I'll have more puzzles for you when the time is right. Stash and Scarfin. All right. I say, isn't that Sherl's pal over there, that yappy dog we met on the hunt for X? You're right, Pinstripes. Looks like this is his territory. Well, in that case, he's bound to know Lisa's house. Go and ask him, Sherl. See if he's heard of the 6 White House horrors. Go on, boy. Go on. All right, stop hounding me. I'll go and bark hello and slip that into conversation when I can. Hi there, Hound. Didn't expect to see you around here. Oh, it's you, Hound. Still got your muzzle to the grindstone with that old sleuthing work, eh? Oh, it's not so bad. Anyway, I was just wondering, do you know the White House that's near here? You mean that really gloomy-looking place? I know it well. Ever seen anything weird there? Like maybe a ghost? What have they got you investigating now? I feel for you, Hound. I feel for you. So, ghosts, well. Have you ever heard of the tale of the sealed cellar? No, that's a new one on me. What's the story? They say that old house has a cellar, and sometimes ghosts show up there. Is that the kind of lowdown you were looking for, Hound? Yeah, thanks. I owe you a treat. According to my sources on the street, we just saw him. Apparently, there's a tale about the cellar in the White Residence. The sealed cellar, he called it. That sounds like another of the six tales. Good boy, Sherl. A cellar with ghosts? I don't like the sound of that. There must be something dangerous hidden down there. Excuse me, what are you trying to keep from me? I can hear you all muttering, you know. We've just learned about another of the six White House horrors, the sealed cellar. Where did you hear that? Who told you? I'm afraid I can't divulge that information, Emiliana. It's sort of a trade secret, you see. Obviously, you private detectives have sources we legitimate lawkeepers wouldn't consider using. When you're as famous as I am, you find some unique leads. Not dog leads, I mean proper investigative leads. What are you talking about? Oh! Look, miss. All the cat paraphernalia has been replaced with iguana trinkets and ornaments. Madame wasn't exaggerating in her letter, was she? Where did she even get this much iguana stuff? Amazon, duh. Suppose a lady of Madame Dublé's standing in wealth can lay her hands on whatever she likes. Well, let's not allow this iguantophobia to distract us from our mission. To ask Madame about the White House horrors. Good evening. I'm sorry to drop in on you unannounced like this. Katrielle, darling! Oh, I'm delighted to see you! And so is Rexy Wexy, of course. Just look at him. Is that a delighted iguana, Emiliana? I'm a profiler and analyst of human behavior, Katrielle. Iguanas are not my thing. I believe we've met before, haven't we? Yes, it was at the Savloy, if I'm not mistaken. That's right, and thank you again for your cooperation in that case. Not at all. Now tell me, what brings you here today? Another case? Actually, we're investigating the so-called Six White House Horrors for Lisa White. Oh yes, of course. It was I who gave Lisa your details, you know. And do you know anything about the strange happenings at the White Residence? One hears tales, yes. I remember one in particular. The Searching Soul, it's called. Souls now. Yes, the story tells of a most petrifying spirit that wanders the corridors of that stately old house. Night after night, it stalks its prey, striking terror into the hearts of any visitors, unfortunate enough to encounter it. Well, the Searching Soul is certainly a blood-curdling tale, madam. Is it, though? That was a shitty synopsis, to be honest. She was always a rather quiet young girl, but ever since her mother and father passed away, she seemed rather in the doldrums. I do hope you'll help find her. Help her. I'm quite sure if anyone can solve the mystery, it's you. Thank you for your confidence in my abilities, madam. Well, I think we know all six of the White House horror stories, don't we? Yes, the ghosts in the garden, the wraith at the window, the possessed puppet, the sealed cellar, the morbid mirror, and the searching soul. Now let's return to the house and determine whether there's any truth in these suspiciously alliterative tales. Good evening again, ladies. Is one to understand that you are now apprised of the details of the six White House horrors? Yes, we found out about all six. Now we'd like to investigate. We need access to the house to do that, of course. Will that be all right? Leave no stone unturned, ma'am. It is Miss White's sincerest hope that you are able to explain these happenings. Let's tackle these tales one by one and see if we can explain what's been going on. You seem suddenly more upbeat. I think it highly likely that these ghosts are nothing more than people's eyes playing tricks. I'm sure that once we investigate, these supernatural phenomena will turn out to be simple illusions. On the other hand, we might prove that they're real. No. Miss Layton, I think it's time you stopped teasing Miss Spaghetti and we started our investigations. Yes, you're right. Let's begin with the first tale we heard, shall we? The ghost in the garden. Wooster said he saw a number of ghosts in the grounds of the house, didn't he? I wonder where in the garden they would have been. According to my notes, Inspector Hastings hasn't got much of a stomach for these kinds of scary cases. So how exactly do we get to the garden? You've heard the six tales. Rumors are spreading through the neighborhood, you know. Okay. It must be something I can see from here somewhere. Something that I can click, no doubt. Did you see that? Eerie light floating up into the sky? Perhaps it was one of the ghosts. I see you found evidence. It's not Waster, Emiliana, it's Wooster! Oh, you appeared out of nowhere, so I thought. Despicable of me to have startled you in that way, ma'am. I beg your pardon. It was exactly like this, the ghosts gathering by night. A big group of ghosts have appeared. They'll run away if they are hit by a flash of light that is the same color as them. The flash can only reach ghosts in the front row, but the ghosts behind them come forward to fill in any gaps. Each color flash has a limited number of uses. Eliminate all of the ghosts using the number of flashes you have at your disposal. Bum 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 bum. I think I get the gist here. Yes, yes. Easy.
I've seen how to solve this now. Any mystery or any puzzle solved.
A most meritorious performance, ma'am. Now, if you'll excuse me. What on earth did he show up for like that? What's that on the floor over there? Ernest, pick it up, would you? Yes, Mies. Are you sure it's not dangerous or cursed? It's a balloon, I think. So it is, a deflated balloon. Do you think the ghost we saw before could have been? Certainly on a dark night, balloons bobbing around in the air could look rather ghostly. But why was it luminous? Are you suggesting the ghosts in the garden were nothing more than a bunch of balloons? I feel this mystery starting to unravel. Let's see what we can find out about this wraith at the window. There are so many windows visible from here. I wonder which one the ghostly figure appeared at. Wit. Oh. Oh, no. Did you see that, Emiliana? A ghostly figure just appeared. There's no need to sound quite so happy about it, Katrielle. Well, it's not every day you see a ghost, is it? We're very lucky. I'd rather win the lottery, personally. Good evening. Another sighting, I believe. Woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo other than the aptly named Wraith the Window. The form, in silhouette at least, is quite removed from that of an ordinary mortal, indeed, as is in this puzzle. As in this puzzle. There is a silhouette of something behind the curtain, made up of three statues. But which ones? Look at the five statues and select which three are the ones hiding behind the curtain. The statues cannot be taken apart and must be used in their entirety. None of them have anything extra on their rear side. And they're overlapped, is that the case? The interesting thing about this one is, you need to realize that if you try and go in the order it gives you, you can't possibly get a head with a fire horn with two protruding arms. But if you flip them upside down, then you can use the green ones as horns, and then that works out. So you'd be using C normally, but A and D are flipped upside down. Then you get what you want. Yep, yep, yep.
Collate the data, and the answer will drop out. Puzzles are really very simple when you know the proper methods.
Any puzzle can be solved with the application of logic. A stirring performance, Miss Spaghetti. Most exceptional. Now, if you'll excuse me. Why does he keep appearing and then disappearing again like that? Isn't that a... Look at this, Emiliana. You wouldn't expect something like this to be hidden in the bushes, would you? A projector? Any image projected from here would look enormous on the wall. So the wraith at the window is just a piece of cinematic trickery. First the so-called ghosts, and now the wraith. Both of them were set up by someone. Which means the remaining four tales of supernatural phenomena may well turn out to be fake too. Yes, which one came next? It was the possessed puppet, wasn't it? Let's head to the living room and carry on our investigations. Here we are back inside then, miss. On to investigating the next of the six happenings. This is where that possessed puppet is supposed to have been, isn't it? The one that moved of its own accord and then cackled loudly. And it's in here somewhere as we speak, probably. Do you know, I can actually feel someone's eyes boring into me. Good evening again. I trust your investigations are progressing favorably. A roof. I say, you did rather startle me. Where, you have a habit of appearing when we least expect you. Wooster. Indeed, ma'am. I endeavor to be present at all times, yet never conspicuously so. It is a butler's duty. It strikes me that butlers are not unlike ghosts, appearing out of nowhere and disappearing again into thin air. Careful, miss. He might hear you. I wish you luck with your investigations. It moved! The puppet here moved even though I didn't lay a paw on it. It's alive! Isn't it sweet? What a lovely face. Such a lovely face. Have a care, sir? All right, I was expecting it that time. He's losing his edge. I remember Miss White as a young child, doting on that very puppet when it was still ordinary. She would play with it rather like these finger puppets, in fact. This is a puppet show with finger puppets on two hands. You need to move the finger puppet so that there's a... I gotta sneeze. Oh, God. Yeah. Excuse me. Move them so the blue on each thumb and red on each little. Okay, I think I understand. Easy. Idea, yeah?
Still no patch on Miss Layton, of course.
I see Lady Layton is blessed not only with exceptional puzzle-solving abilities, but also an exceptional puzzling solver. Thank you, Wooster. I do my utmost to be a worthy member of the Layton Detective Agency. In fact, miss, I think I may have discovered something important. What is it? Look here. There's some sort of device inside this puppet. So there is. You sniffed that out pretty quickly, Pinstripes. I was thinking to myself that the puppet's movements looked rather mechanical somehow. That would explain how the puppet was able to move without anybody touching it. So this is just a wind-up doll. I really don't see what all the fuss is about here. Why are people so scared of these obvious childish pranks? Says the woman who is cowering behind a chair. What is the matter with your dog, Katrielle? Why does she always bark at me like that? Yes, well, there are only 3 of the 6 White House horror stories left now. Next it was... The sealed cellar. We'll have to find a way down there. A cellar, sir. I've been in service here at the White residence for a considerable number of years, but not once have I heard mention of a cellar, nor have I seen any evidence of one. I didn't think old Terror Eyes would let us down there. Looks like we'll have to sniff out the entrance ourselves. I don't imagine it'll be easy to find. After all, it's called the sealed cellar. So this is gonna be fun. Well, it's been over 30 minutes, so I'm gonna end this video here. So stay tuned for the next episode, and thanks for watching. Bye-bye!